There's a movement happening in Dysart schools in this 21st century learning environment. It's a new culture, a new mindset, a new way for students to have open-ended exploration. It's a place for students to create, invent, tinker, explore, and discover using a variety of tools and processes. It's called the Makerspace Movement. To describe them simply, makerspaces are collaborative environments with a set of tools to encourage authentic learning experiences. They combine technologies, collaboration, and education for the purposes of enabling students to design, prototype, and create for solution-focused thinking.
It's interesting that businesses and the people that we are ultimately serving, we're creating workers for the workforce, they're asking us for people that are problem solvers and will attack a problem and be able to have the ability to persevere through adversity and to be able to have things not work and maybe fail a couple times but still stick with the task at hand and at the end of the day actually be able to solve that problem. And this is one of those things that is really key in building those skills within students.
What's important to note first is that makerspaces in the Dysart School District can take many forms and vary greatly from school to school. Makerspaces might focus on electronics, robotics, programming and coding, and even arts and sewing. Makerspaces can also take place at any time of the day. The maker culture in a classroom is oftentimes grounded within a lesson and the curriculum, whereas before or after school makerspaces focus on a tinkering aspect that allows students to explore their ideas in a less structured setting. This is called a personalized spectrum. There is personalization for the learner, in which the teacher tailors the learning, and personalization by the learner, in which the student develops skills to tailor his or her own learning.
And that's kind of just the general philosophy of a makerspace. It is a space that has all different kinds of options that the students can use to learn and solve these problems or use for these projects. But how they choose to use the tools and what tools they choose to use are their choice. It's personalized to them. So the makerspace philosophy in Dysart lends itself very well to personalization.
Makerspaces in the district also utilize something called the design thinking process. Design thinking is a method for practical, creative resolution of problems and the creation of solutions.
The beauty of design thinking is that it's really a structure or a framework that allows students to collaborate and think critically about what they're doing. And what's great about it is it doesn't wrap students into a box. It doesn't tell them what to think or how to think. It really nurtures creativity and divergent problem solving so that they can go forth and have that maker mindset and create and solve.
The tools utilized in Dysart Makerspaces sound like something out of a Dr. Seuss book. Students explore with Little Bits, Mickey Makeys, Cubelets, Arduinos, Tinkercad, and Raspberry Pi. 3D printers are also usually a staple within a makerspace and provide students the opportunity to create a physical prototype that they can test and refine through observation.
If you think about it, the world around us is being automated. The Internet of Things is right on the precipice right now. We're hanging on the edge, and these kids that are going through the system right now are going to be movers and shakers with those things. So these are real college and career ready skills that we want them to have. It's the computational thinking that goes into it. It's the programming logic. It's the learning how to understand schematics, and it's very scientific.
For example, in Mr. Len's class at Mountain View, 7th graders have identified a problem with sewage where the Mississippi River meets the Gulf of Mexico. Using the program Tinkercad, they are exploring ways to design spillways that would prevent or decrease the amount of material being dumped into the sea.
The water would flow in through the opening at the front, and then all of the materials would get stuck in the ridges on the side and the bottom, and then it would flow out through the other end so that only the water that didn't have all the materials that could be causing dead zones would go through. There was no restrictions, so we could pretty much do whatever we wanted as long as it would help with the situation. When we write, sometimes we're just like looking things up and think, oh, people think this, so it's not our theories, it's other people's, and this is what we think. We're putting our knowledge into something that could actually help.
Makerspaces and the design thinking process are being utilized together in Dysart schools as a way to shape active creators, collaborators, and designers versus passive consumers. They're a way to inspire wonder and celebrate unique solutions to the problems of the future.
A maker mindset is a philosophy, it's a way of being. And it's really important that Dysart embodies this and embraces this because these students are the future. These students are gonna go out into the real world eventually and they're gonna fail. It's gonna happen and they can't control that. But what we can help control as educators is we can try to foster these skills in them so that when they do go out into the real world and fail, they don't quit, they don't give up. They become problem solvers. They become a critical thinker. They try and reach out to other colleagues and collaborate because that's what's going to make them a powerhouse in the workforce. And that's what I'm really excited about with the maker mindset.